In this video, we're going to talk about security groups and how those work within point of sale. In previous videos, we've gone through adding a new employee and how you assign them to a specific security group, or maybe modifying an existing employee to change which group they're assigned to. But in this video, we're going to actually go through how to access those groups. So from our employees menu, I'm either going to click security, or maybe if I already had my employee list pulled up, then I could also choose View Edit Security Rights from the I Want To menu. Over here in the left column, we've got the column header Security Rights. So this is a list of all of the areas of point of sale or tasks that can be accomplished within the point of sale software. Our subsequent columns, we've got Owner, Manager, Assistant Manager, and Associate. These are the default groups within point of sale, and what you do is check the box if that owner is allowed to create payout receipts. If they're not, then you would uncheck the box. Then what you do is assign your employees to these specific groups. So your associates would not be able to create payout receipts, but your assistant manager, manager, or owner could. This is a pretty lengthy list, but you can also search for security rights by entering in. For instance, if I want to see everything that was related to items, then I could just click item, click the search button, and I could just continue hitting enter, and everything that has the word item in it is going to show up here highlighted in blue. Another thing that you could do is add a new group. So let's say I had employees that worked in my stockroom, and I had a workstation back there, and I didn't want them to be able to make a sale, but I wanted them to have access to anything that was related to vouchers. So I could add a new group called stockroom. Then I could just search for the word voucher and give them access to that. Search for voucher again and give them access to that. That way, any employees that I assign to my stockroom group can accomplish these tasks, but they can't do any of the other ones, like make a sale or make a return or any of those things. I could also edit the name of my group if I wanted to, or delete this group. But you cannot edit or make changes to the default group. So owner, manager, assistant manager, and associate are there to stay. But stockroom, I could rename that group if I wanted to something different. Maybe if I had two stockroom groups. So this would be my stockroom 2 group. Or I could delete the group. Now if I delete the stockroom 2 group, it's going to ask me where I want to assign any employees that may be assigned to that stockroom 2 group, what group I want to make them members of now. So I'm going to say associate and then click delete group. Now my stockroom 2 group is gone. When I click save, then I have changed the security rights.